I'm here in the studio recording Da Vinci's Demons with our vocal contractor and singer, Bobbi Page. The sound of a choir is really integrated into the whole soul of my score, and we're using it in multiple episodes.
I love it because we get to feel the show grow. We started with men and then had a women's group, and that made a different timbre.
It's definitely a different experience for me, because we walk into the room and even the first couple hours will be, you know, we move really slow because we're trying different sounds, and it's not only the people, I think also the room. With strings and brass, those differences exist, but they're pretty subtle. You can dial it in pretty fast. But with singers, it's just a lot more subjective.
Okay. It's nice. What I'd like to do is just readjust top voice a little breathier. And back off, like just bring the dynamics down. Okay. Two inner voices, let's bring you up a lot.
Okay.
There was one cue in particular that we did where I wanted humming.
Mm-hmm.
But I'd written it a little high. And what's funny is that once you were humming, you were actually humming. But up in that register, it doesn't sound like humming.
No, it doesn't.
You know?
Sounds a little bit like bees.
Yeah, exactly.
Because it's not a, it's not a real vowel. It's more of a schwa sound.
Yeah.
What we do as singers is change it in the mask, in the mouth.
Yeah.
And then you can get the humming sound.
The other thing that working with you and your groups that I get to do, there's this whole other dimension of meaning, which is the text. We're doing a Renaissance mass. And as he would pronounce the lines, he would also translate them.
Yes, that was beautiful.
And it was interesting, because I wouldn't have thought to say, hey guys, this is what this is actually saying.
Mm-hmm.
But after he said, well, this is what it's actually saying in English,
mm-hmm.
even I felt like, I'm gonna think about this a little differently now.
There are things that you just can accomplish with the human voice that you can't accomplish otherwise.
Yeah, I mean, it immediately takes us to a time and place, and the ability to set text, even if we don't understand the text, we hear that Latin,
right.
We hear those old liturgical
right.
pieces.
We may not understand the Latin, but we know it's Latin. One of the other things that's nice about what we've been able to do with the show is a lot of shows, I think, are composed without any live musicians. It's all
absolutely.
It's all digital.
Yeah.
And trust me, I'd like to have even more. But we have a lot.
Yeah.
We have a lot of live musicians.
We do. No, we do. And they and we really make the most out of them. Been such a useful ally, I have to be more subjective and describe to you what I want, because I haven't worked with a choir often enough to say, hey, let's change that vowel on that note, or move a player around, or let's rehearse that start.
I think we do that really well.
Yeah.
Because I do understand, I think, when you say, I want more of this, but I need to bring a tenor over, or bring a soprano down, or just do it instantaneously, not have a big discussion, because we don't have time.
Right, exactly.
And you trust me enough to to do the fix, and I understand you so that I can make that fix and you'll get it right away.
Yeah.
And so we moved up a baritone, or we moved down a tenor. Or
and it's great, because then we can try an idea, and most of the time it works, but even if it doesn't work, then we know, okay, that's not it, let's try something else, and we can work very quickly. It's getting to explore and kind of make music by doing this and waving my arms around and feeling the music just comes at you. And for me, where I spend 95% of this process in a room by myself, playing samples and synthesizers and writing stuff down, to be able to come to the home stretch here and make music with wonderful singers, it's a real thrill. Here's to hoping we'll be doing this again on season 2.
Yeah. Oh yeah.